Hello there, Ali here for Sports Templates, and today we're going to be working on this new logo slash text mockup where you can create 3D logos, 3D texts, and multi-layered 3D logos as well. So in this mockup pack, you're going to get six PSDs. The first one is going to be this wide view of a single logo, and it includes the 3D multi-layered logo and 3D text as well. This mockup comes in three different aspect ratios. We got the widescreen view, we got the portrait view, or you call it a story view, and the square view, which is 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels square. And also you will get the team versus team view. And this one has two logos, both has two layers of 3D effect that you can change, and it comes with different backgrounds and the team name as well. This one also comes in wide view, square view, and the story view. And today I'm going to be doing two designs using this mockup. One using the text, the 3D text effect, and the other one using the team versus team 3D logo effect. So to get started, I want to start with the story aspect ratio for the first one. And for this one, I'm not going to go with the 3D logo. I'm going to do the 3D text. I'm going to run you through how you can create your own designs with it. So to get started, you can just go to 3D text folder right here, open it up, and you can see this layer with the purple color, which means this layer is editable. You can just go and click on this icon, the smart object thumbnail icon, and double click on it. And then you see that we have here text written. It's against kind of a white background, so it's hard to see, but you can always change the color of the text to see it better. But for now, I'm gonna do a simple poster, kind of like a story mockup, story design. And for this one, I'm gonna do something for Leo Messi. He just won the World Cup. I thought it would be cool to do a design for him. So I'm just gonna write his name right here. And all I have to do is get out of this file and save. And you can see the text has already been updated. Everything for the text has been updated. It generated shadows, depth, and textures for it. And it's just ready to go. This is a done design at this point if you want, but we can always push it further. So if you go down to background designs, you can see we have all these different designs that we can add to the background to kind of like add more style to our design. And they're all vector shapes. You can change their color. You can do any kind of combinations with them. But for this one, I'm just gonna go with the stripes because it looks more like Argentina's jersey. And I'm just gonna leave it like this and then save. The background color, you have a bunch of options here. I went with light blue because it is also the Argentina color, but you can try all kinds of colors here, and all of these layers are editable, so you can always choose your own colors and do your own combinations. So I'm gonna get back to the light blue and let's save it for now. And then we got the top and the bottom text. So the top text is just dummy text that says Sports Templates Presents. And the bottom text is the same, just random text that you can change to be whatever text you want. You can also hide them if you want to, but I'm gonna leave them for now. The last thing you want to do is, if you go back to the 3D text, there's also another text called secondary text. You can double click on it, and instead of your, this it was saying your text, you can just see layer now. And at this point, we're pretty much done. What we can do is, I've added this crown shape, but you can add any kind of shape you want, any kind of design you want in the background to it. But the last thing you can do at this point is you can just go back to here. You have the depth shadows layer. This is where all the effects for the text are happening. So let's say, for example, you come in here and you can see the depth layer. If you click on the depth layer and go to color overlay, it has like a whitewash on it. But if you wanted to reflect the background more, let's say we want it to be more blue, you can change it just so it would fit more. And then you can, if it's too dark, you can always go with like a lighter color, or even go for something super saturated and then drop the opacity a little bit. This is just to kind of add that extra level of realism to your decks to make sure that it kind of responding to its environment. So, but for now, I'm just going to keep it as is. Another layer is wall reflection. So in this design, we have the light coming from top. You can see the shadows are dropping down. So usually when you have a bright light kind of hitting any object, it kind of creates what's called a bounce light. And this bounce light is kind of like bouncing back on the wall behind it. This is, if you can turn it, you can see it's a really subtle effect, but it does make a difference. And you can always go to opacity and control how harsh this effect is going to be. I think 35% is a good number, so we'll just leave it at that. And you can always go to the shadows layers if you want darker shadows. Both of these, I have two layers of shadows. Both of these are 50% filled, so you can always go up if you want to get like more defined shadows as well. So this is it for the text mockups. And at this point, you know, we did everything for the background. You can just hide it and load the logo, and you can just add any logo you want at this point as well, if you want a multi-layered logo. So now moving on to the second type of mockup that comes with this mockup pack. We got this one, the team versus team logo mockup. And for this one, I prepared a little library that we can use the logos from and kind of like changed it to this design. So to get started, you have the mockup split between left logo and right logo. So going with the right logo, each logo has two different layers. We got the bottom part and you got the top part. So let's start with the bottom part and let's go with the ducks. So I'm going to share a link to this library with you in the description below, so you can just follow along with me. So if you double click on this, it's going to open the logo like this. You just drag and drop. Hide the placeholder logo I have here, and now we have the whole logo. If we click Control S to save it, you will get something like this. We have the top layer, so we can just hide it to see how it looks, and you can see we do have this 3D logo look, but everything is flat and it's on the same layer. So to separate it, we need to go back in and then hide everything but the bottom parts. So for that, it's going to be the black and the white shapes. So let me just hide all of this and click Control S and then go back to the top layer. And this is really important that when you copy the logo from the bottom to the top, while you can open both layers next to each other like this, and while you copy it, you just keep clicking Shift so it falls exactly in the same place. So I'm just going to select the folder for the logo, deep clicking Shift while I drag and drop it into the second one. And then in the second one, I'll do the exact opposite, which is hide the bottom layers and then unhide the top layers. And at this point, you just click Control S to save. The same for this one. And just need to turn on the top layer to see the difference. And there you have it. You can see that now we have the logo in 3D. It looks like two 3D layers on top of each other. You got the base layer that's kind of like on top of the wall texture. And then there's another 3D layer on top of it. And you got this unique kind of 3D logo look that you find in sports broadcasts or social media posts. And at this point, we just need to do the left logo. Left logo is basically the same process. I'll open the Fox logo right here. Let me just put it all in the folder. And then drop it here. Just hide it. And then for the back of the logo, for the base of the logo, I want to add a stroke, so I can just go to stroke right here. Do outside. Let's make it off-white, and let's do something like 18 pixels. Now we need to open the top layer as well, so we'll do the same thing. I'll select the logo folder, and while dragging, keep pressing shift, and you got it in the exact same place. But for this one, I'm just gonna keep the top parts. Let's save. And for here, before we close it, let's hide the top parts and save. What is left is just changing the background colors. So for the background, I'm gonna do this gray that I have it in the library right here. And for the ducks, it's the screen. It's basically a little bit lighter than the green you have in the template. And you have them all separated here. You got right team and left team. One more thing we can do is change the team name and team city. So we're gonna name this one Toronto Ducks. When I did this logo, tried to make the duck head look more like a maple leaf. It's kind of feel it's gonna be fitting to be a Toronto team. This font I'm using is called Apotec Extra Wide. It's a free font that you can find online if you look for it, and just make sure that you install it if you want to use this exact font. Otherwise, you can just use any font you want. And for you, we can do a foxes, and let's make it a Miami team. The verses here is also editable. You can add any text here, or even remove it. And at this point, it's pretty much done. We made this 3D team versus team logo graphic, and we made this kind of like a poster using the 3D text feature. I made this mockup to be a useful resource for you to be able to do 3D logos and texts without having to deal with all the 3D programs. This gives you a pretty realistic and clean look for 3D texts and logos. And it's all done within Photoshop. It only takes a few minutes to do each design. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And if you use this mockup online, please tag sports templates. Would love to see you work and feature your sports on our Hall of Fame. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We got a lot of interesting templates coming out in 2023. We're doing more animation stuff. So stay tuned and see you guys in the next one.